for demonstration purposes, I have a small game here. I have some parts in workspace which will be used as spawners. These all have a property which shows the name of the item they spawn. There's also tools in replicated storage and these spawners will spawn gears here. I have a remote event in this folder, which will be used in this video, and my scripts which I control on VS Code. Please ignore this redlined part for now, it's not a wrong code. I will quickly explain what this script does. I defined my required variables here in the first 5 lines. And then there is my function, onSpawnerAdded. This will run for every spawner. Inside this function, there is a touched event which starts with the classic debounce method. After that, it checks if touched part is a part of a player's character. If it is, it fires a remote event to server. On the for loop, it gets all parts tagged with spawner tag, and applies the function to them. And we also have the event for new additions. On the server part, we have an event for our remote, so server can receive these event calls. Inside this function bound to event, we copy the item specified, and then put it to player's character. As you can see, it works perfectly. You might think that this is the right way to do it. However, it's not. There are some exploits which will let exploiters view remote event activity on their developer console. Even if you disable this console, they can still view it on an user interface object, or just see local scripts. Exploiters have the ability of viewing local scripts with some tools. With these, they can see what you use as arguments. This also means that having a remote event key is a cheap solution, and can be beaten easily. These remote events can be fired by clients manually. I'll show how easy it is on the console here. Exploits have their own code executing environment and they are more advanced than the command bar Roblox Studio has. Keep an eye on the console. I can easily fire this remote event like how we use these on scripts and I can get these tools without stepping on these spawners. It's as easy as that for an exploiter. There are some weird methods on the internet about securing these remote events like naming them with the new line characters. These are never the real solutions for this, and these can be bypassed too. Real solution for this problem is checking these on server. In this case, you can just use a touched event for this part on server. However, in cases where client needs to send some local data to server, like some input data, then required checks need to be done on server side. I disabled my example scripts and I'll show this built-in script for spawner here. It's listening to the event on server, but in some cases, this could hurt your performance. Letting client pick up some load of fuzz is okay, but make sure to not trust clients fully. For example, if you have a gun script, you should always do some checks on server, like if your gun has enough ammo, and if ray casted by the gun actually hit a player. These were some basic examples, just so you can understand, but clients can manipulate pretty much every data they send. So what I'll do right now is, I'll move these spawners somewhere else on my client side, and see if they work. I can just grab the move tool, and move it to somewhere else. This would give me some advantages over other players. I could have spawners close to me. But as you can see, it doesn't work. Reason is we didn't actually change where it is for server. This is running a server script and for server, it's still there. If you want to practice what you have learned a bit, I have a challenge for you. Fix the security vulnerabilities on this place without using these default scripts. Place download link will be in the description. That was it for this video. Hope you understood. See you in another one.